The number of confirmed mpox cases in Uganda has risen to 222, with the capital, Kampala, registering the highest number of new infections at 85, according to the mpox outbreak in Uganda situation update on October 28, 2024. A total of 41 cases have been confirmed in Nakasongola and 39 in Wakiso, with 21 districts affected. Two new confirmed cases were reported, one each in the districts of Kasese and Maracha. One death has been recorded, translating into a case fatality rate of 0.45%. According to the report, 27 cases were yet to be moved to treatment units. Currently, 111 patients are in admission and 84 people have recovered. The other districts with confirmed cases are Mayuge 13, Kasese, where the outbreak started, has 9, and then Mukono has 6. The treatment units with active admissions are in the districts of Nakaseke, Nakasongola, Kasese, Wakiso, Adjumani, Kabale, Sinjiro, Bulisa, Dokolo, and Mbarara. Mpox is a zoonotic disease transmitted from animals to human beings through handling or consuming infected animals such as squirrels, rats, mice, or monkeys. It can also be spread from the infected human being to another through direct physical contact such as kissing or sexual contact with an infected person. Conservation efforts are underway to restore the catchment area surrounding Nyombe wetland in Kahunja sub-county, Kabale district. Local authorities alongside community members have launched a campaign to protect this 300-hectare wetland, which spans 70 kilometers. Recently, officials from the Ministry of Water and Environment and Kabale District demarcated the wetland to safeguard it from further encroachment. Henry Tumwesije, the District National Resources Officer, emphasized that the project's success depends on encouraging sustainable land use around the wetland's catchment areas and that authorities are now implementing the measures.
Now, as this campaign kicks off, we have decided to take back these people, but using one sensitization, talking to them, sensitizing them so that they can be able to leave the wetland area and occupy and go back to the hills. Now here government, first of all, is going to give them what we call alternative economic livelihood, like goats, pigs, poultry and so on and so forth.
Kabale resident district commissioner Godfrey Nyakahuma pointed out that increased encroachment has brought significant climatic challenges to the region, making restoration efforts essential.
He realized that all that has been not under production because of surface runoff. So as a project, we have supported the district to undertake one of the government rules of hills and mountain regulations.
Donald Trump dismissed claims that he or his supporters were comparable to Nazis after his rally in Madison Square Garden drew widespread criticism from opponents for crude and racist remarks from several speakers. The event drew comparisons to a 1939 pro-Nazi rally in the same venue.
And yet they use that word freely, both words. They use it, he's Hitler. And then they say, he's a Nazi. I'm not a Nazi. I'm the opposite of a Nazi. I don't know.
At a rally in Wisconsin, Trump's running mate J.D. Vance sidestepped criticism over comedian Tony Hinchcliffe's racist remarks about Puerto Rico. As he and rival Kamala Harris, the current vice president, entered the final stretch of one of the closest U.S. elections in modern times, each candidate and their teams have ramped up the political rhetoric, inflaming an already tense campaign.